Joining us now is former Assistant Secretary of State Jamie Rubin, now a counselor to New York Governor Andrew Cuomo. Jamie, good morning to you.
Good morning.
Before we talk about the larger and now fractured U.S.-Pakistani relationship, more immediately, the closed border at this point, a danger to U.S. troops?
Not yet. The military stockpiles support and supplies for many, many weeks. There are other routes in. Because of the difficulty of the U.S. relationship with Pakistan, the military has developed routes through the north. But if
difficult
routes, and as this time goes on, it could become a problem of getting critical supplies, but not right now.
This is the last thing that the U.S. needs right now, is any further friction in terms of its relationship with Pakistan. Where does it go from here? Because this remains, as tumultuous as it is, an incredibly important relationship for the U.S.
I think it's fair to say since 9/11, Pakistan has been the epicenter of the international conflict that's resulted from those attacks, both because terrorists come from Pakistan and, crucially, because its policy on Afghanistan will determine whether we can succeed there. And that's the problem. Pakistan really has not behaved like an ally of the United States in the past, and it probably won't in the future. So how do you deal with an ally, a country who's not behaving as an ally, but yet whose support you need to make Afghanistan a success? That's the problem.
And is there an answer?
Here's a question. Everyone talks about how important this relationship is, not saying that it's not, but I thought John Huntsman said something very interesting over the weekend. He said, I would recognize exactly what the U.S.-Pakistani relationship has become, which is merely a transactional relationship. Are we expecting too much of this relationship?
Well, I think it's also true that both President Bush and President Obama have sugarcoated the reality, have not really leveled with the American people about how Pakistan's behavior really is inconsistent, and it's not fair and true to call them a real partner. And so perhaps if we were to be more candid about the difficulties, then the expectations would drop, and when one of these incidents happened, we wouldn't throw our hands up because we wouldn't expect Pakistan to be behaving like an ally.
And stop calling them a true partner, just call them a business ally, a necessary business ally.
Well, I mean, look, they're both an ally and they're an enemy at times. You know, the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, the American number one soldier, just a couple of months ago, Admiral Mullen, stated that the Pakistani intelligence service supports our principal enemy in Afghanistan, the Haqqani network. So they're not just not a friend. Sometimes they're supporting the enemy.
In terms of the sugarcoating that you say has gone on and the statements about the need to be more transparent, is there a concern that in that transparency, the relationship is further damaged and the bit of good that the U.S. does get for it is further threatened?
Well, that is the problem. I think if we developed a more mature policy in which we could be candid with the public, and this is crucial, the Congress about how difficult it is to maintain both a relationship with the military, support them when we get something back, but also be clear about the problems. In the Republican debate this past week, the issue of this aid to Pakistan was really complicated, and nobody could agree on it. And that's why presidents are reluctant to be fully honest about Pakistan, because they're worried about losing those aid dollars that we need in order to get support when Pakistan does provide it, which is real and does help us in the case of drones to kill terrorist activities.
Mm-hmm. No easy answer.
Jamie Rubin, my sense is we'll see you again on this issue. Thank
Jamie,
you very much.
Thank you.